With a yo-ho-ho, it's TaleOfTheToaster. Welcome to some more Inazuma 11 GO Galaxy, where this time we're going to be kicking off the Legend Gates. So this is kind of a hybrid between post-game and not. This particular Legend Gate is actually available halfway through the game. We're going to be starting with all the Legend Gates that are available before you beat the game and then move into the ones that are available afterwards, which also kind of coincidentally works out as in order of difficulty. So this time we're going to be playing by far the easiest, one that is easy on purpose. You click the blue exclamation mark and it opens a gate to a legendary battle in a parallel universe. We will crush you! Resistance National versus Inazuma National has returned! Yes, that's a call for Bailong to appear then. Inazuma National, we will crush you! Huh? Crush? What do you mean? You will soon see by fighting us! Let's go! We will, but not in the manner that you expect. These Legend Gates are designed to let you take the form of usually a previous form of Raimon or Inazuma Japan, but in this case, we will be taking the form of Resistance National against Inazuma National. So each one of these Legend Gates creates a new scenario from the Inazuma 11 canon, to let you play it from either a different perspective or just kind of a recreation that's more accurate than it was before. So we'll go over some more of those when we actually have some different ones to play. But for now, the Resistance National versus Inazuma National match has good reason to be one. I'll take a look at the movesets first, because again, we're controlling these guys. They have their fighting spirits, but you can't use them, so we're still reliant purely on their moves. I cannot also change the formation on this screen, so Harold Houdini will stay there for now. But you know, we could make this entirely Cronus Four Seasons run if we wanted. Actually, he's got a long shot, so he's kind of in the right spot already. Dodge is there with his good stats. Bailong right in the middle, of course, has had plenty of opportunities already in this series. But let's just try and get a bit of use out of everybody here, because there are no reserves on the bench. I want to try and use everyone at least once. And then Inazuma National are our opponents. So again, this is reflective of when they were level 20. So Falco is still a happy-go-lucky guy. No one's got their totems. Even the fighting spirits have been removed from players like Ricardo. And only Blamdunk to deal with on Terry. Basically, the reason that this serves as a Legend Gate is because when we played this match as Inazuma National, as long as you're at least a little bit overlevelled, you can actually win that match. You're at a significant disadvantage, but that match is still entirely winnable, and even if you do lose, I might have, for example, only lost 1-0. The story kind of implies that Resistance National absolutely crushes Inazuma National here, and in the anime it's something like 8-0 or whatever, like it's a complete walkover. But when you're the one playing as Inazuma National, there's no real accurate way to do that. Sucker something from Bailong. Yeah, it just doesn't, never quite translated across to the game when you either can win or need to lose on purpose. So what they did was include this match again as the introduction to Legend Gates that basically say, all right, this time do it properly. You can play as Resistance National and absolutely go to town on an Inazuma National that is 5 levels lower than you. And that's what I intend to do. I just want to try and use all of the players and utterly annihilate them, because they don't have shot blocks, they don't have stuff like you know, totems and fighting spirits, or just really anything. Like, Buddy, does he even have his long shot yet? I don't remember. Some of our moves are fully evolved, like this Sonic shot. Blamdunk would have been able to stop that. Soccer, same statement again. That could have been easily stopped by Terry, but he didn't want to. He's going to let us keep running away with it. So that's fine. Let's use our other actual defender to make a slight mock. I don't need sideswipe. I could just do a sliding tackle, but might as well do something with everyone at some point. He doesn't have any purpose other than that sideswipe. Who else wants a run? We've scored with Dodge. We've scored with Liverpudlian Gentleman. Dodge has just teleported. I guess Quintet can have a shot of his own. Maybe that's the goal. We go for 11-0 with a goal from everyone. Is it possible? No, he can't score. He doesn't. Simply doesn't have the means. Uh-oh. Looks like it's Bailong time. Keenan's not going to make an effort. Let's hear him do the White Hurricane. White Hurricane! Wouldn't normally do that Japanese style, but seeing as he's going to have a goal celebration afterwards, why not? Zeus! That's the only other one I remember. Obviously a shout out to the Albanian entry from Eurovision 2012 there. Bailong, now that he's done his shot, is actually kind of not necessary, so we'll just shove him to the back here. Quintet is also totally without purpose. So four seasons, you can go there because Dodge has had at least one goal already. Let's go. Yeah, so Legend Gates in general then, they do not have a reward of any kind. Like, I'm not going to gain experience points for beating this. I'm not going to get an item for this. There isn't even, like, an achievement in the game, to my knowledge, that says, wow, you beat this Legend Gate, or you've beaten all the Legend Gates. It is purely for fun and just experiencing a different scenario. And it's a little bit cheap, like, to say that they're spread around the world and some of them are actually quite difficult. I think they could have at least put some kind of small reward in for winning them. Back to your original soccer or something. I've mentioned in other videos that now that we're in the post-game and Arion doesn't have to be our captain, you can actually choose who your captain will be, and if they have voiced lines in the game already by being a captain of another team that's allowed to speak in game, so basically a captain of any team in Go 1, 2, and 3, and a couple of exceptions as well. Many characters will actually be able to have voice lines as your captain now. So Bailong, if I set him as captain, I could have Seuss as one of my lines. Ozrock in particular sets a bit of a lofty end goal because you can recruit him deep into the post game, and your reward for doing it, it's not just access to your own radiation storm. Sure, let's get our Quentin Cinquedea involved. But if I had Ozrock as my captain, I would hear his voice every time I scored a goal. So that's a lot of stuff to aspire towards. But for now, we'll just have our own Bailong as Resistance National and keep the punishment going. There's your involvement, Cinquedea. I, of course, wanted to do that on purpose. Houdini can afford an illusion ball, but I don't think he'd be able to afford Will-O-The-Wisp shot afterwards. So let's just try and do a run with him solo. You can get past Therese and Buddy pretty comfortably. To be honest, the bigger challenge here is the time limit. He's considerably better than the characters he's facing off with right now, but he's still low leveled, so he's not got much of a speed stat. It's better than the speed stat of the opponents, but that was a long run up the pitch just to finally give us the Will-O-The-Wisp shot version 4. I'm not going to have many people left to score with at this rate. But basically, yeah, so Legend Gates, I think they're a really nice idea. This is one of the more creative ones where we actually get to play as Resistance National. Takuno something or other. It means that all of these players that you wouldn't have otherwise recruited and did canonically lose to, even if you actually beat them, now's your chance to actually just free roam with them. And when you've beaten this match, if you really wanted, like, if there was one player that you failed to score with and be like, oh no, I didn't get to see Kirk's shooting animation, you can just play it again. Like, the Legend Gate doesn't go away. You can do it as many times as you like. So that's a good thing about these as well. Again, shame there's no reward, but that's the last I'll harp on it, because they're still a better inclusion to have, especially from a content perspective. Like, boom, this is about 9 videos out the gate, and they're all genuinely, I think, worth covering. Like, some of them will just be replications of matches that I've already beaten in, say, previous Let's Play videos. But at least whenever it's a match you've seen before, the Legend Gates have actually been balanced so that you're kind of a level that makes more sense. Say if it's a final boss, they're actually going to make you a lower level than that final boss. Keep it coming, Bailong. Who else have we got? We've got 6 goals. The defenders are well out of the picture. Unless you count Harold Houdini as one. Njord hasn't actually done anything yet. I forgot about that because he is on my permanent team in Supernova. So I have scored with Njord Snow a lot. But hey up, here's my first chance in Go Galaxy Big Bang. You won't get to see me do out in this one. Yes, my voice is still absolute same as Sean Frost. That's what the Inazuma 11 series decided to do. So again, just outrun your defenders. Most of them barely don't even have moves in the first place. Here's my Snowstorm Leopard. Can't use me fighting spirit, which was something I complained about in story, but I think this is more fun. Blams! The blam miss. Blam dunk failure animation, so funny. Okay, 7-0. So the dream is not dead for the defender goals, but let's just do everything that we can feasibly come up with. Who hasn't done one yet? Within the menu, Dave Jones is next in line, and he's got a long shot, so it's not especially challenging. After that, we'll see if we can have a defender run. To be honest, I'm going to fire the long shot now and see if it actually scores it. I don't think it will. Flying Fish is really weak in this game, and it's only going to lose more power as it goes along. But let's truly see how badly Terry wants to block. Ah, yes, they do have one shot block. There we go. Get some demonstration out of our actual protagonists. Ayin Satsu! To obviously... Hang on. Let's set this up. Dave Jones, you can have your goal, and then we'll just go back to the... But he's actually doing way better for this Inazuma National than he is doing whenever I was using him. That's for sure. But now, I'm afraid he's frozen in ice. That's it for him, really. Back to the... All right, Dave Jones, guess we won't count on you there. That's 2 failures in a row. Take it back from Zippy. Just do your Adekebe moment. In fact, Adekebe actually took the move from this guy, weirdly enough, but we don't want to see it that way around. But yeah, so I think the total number of Legend Gates available before you beat the game is 4. And then the amount after you beat the game is either 4 or 5. Oh, hello, we're going to see special tactics. We have 0 space. That's so overkill. Taking that from Team Zero. Virtuoso stands no chance here. Come on, Dave Jones, you can only afford one more. If he's going to be the only non-defender that I failed to score with, then that's pretty bad going on him. He's offside at the moment, so I actually can't pass to him. I should actually check just to make complete sure that the Fighting Spirit button is great. Yeah, it's completely gone. Definitely can't use it. Terry's actually stepping up his game. This is kind of the point of the Resistance National match. I've shown how powerful the strikers are, and now I'm showing Ray Dark's actual idea of putting Inazuma National against some of the best teams available and making us lose to them until we get better. And now Terry is actually making some saves. Snowstorm Leopard is a bit too much for him, but you know, he's made a couple saves in a row. Big up the lad and lets it through, but he's getting better. There we go. We are successfully training Inazuma National and doing our purpose. So there we go. There isn't a great deal else to say about Resistance National, but I'm certainly looking forward to going through all of these other Legend Gate matches in a row, just to see what else is outstanding. Dodge still has plenty of moves left, but come on, Davy Jones, this is down to you. Don't make this hard on yourself. We've got 7 minutes left to go and make it 9-0, and then that gives us one last chance to just run around with the defenders and see if we can do anything. Frank is the most useless of the opponents. He's got fancy footwork, which he can only afford to do once, and most of the time he doesn't. It's actually leveled up, which I didn't realize, but you know, once he makes one block, Actually, Bannett has managed to get past four seasons. Well, I won't speak too soon, shall I? But here we go.
I don't have Njord's voice. I'm from the same team, but I'm somewhat more cool and mysterious. And I nearly passed to Ricardo because I thought he was part of the team.
Zippy and Keenan, you don't have shot blocks even at the best of times. Like, stats-wise, are some of the best defenders going. They've got great moves. They work very well as a duo. But unfortunately, that is one of their main weaknesses as defenders.
Sumanana.
I'm butchering so much Japanese today. But there we go. All nine forwards have secured a goal. Dodge, you does count as a forward as well. Fine, let's get cocky then. For the final minute, Quentin can go for it. Can go for a sliding tackle instead. There we go, he's won. Falco, you're rubbish, mate. You've been beaten out by the goalkeeper. Fifth sector reigns supreme. Caleb Stonewall will take this team on to save the universe, which they'll commandingly succeed in doing so because they're better than Inazuma National ever was.
Sorry, guys. My trick's too confusing for you.
So there we go. No experience. No any.
Sorry, there is a reward. We got one red friendship token. The most common friendship token in the game. But we've got one. We know what we were missing. I should say thank you.
You get a teeny tiny bit of post-match dialogue after you win a match. That is your only real reward, just one to two lines of dialogue. But the main thing is getting to play as other characters that we wouldn't do otherwise. So, that's the first of many Legend Gates to come. I've been Tale of the Toaster, and we'll see you in the next one. Toodaloo.